Hey guys, in today's video, we'll be taking a look at probably 5 of the strongest free-to-play teams in the game right now. I haven't done much videos on S-Rank for Tandy, so you know she had to make an appearance here. We will be using her signature functor since her and her functor are accessible to free-to-play players. Of course, we'll have some Selene gameplay as well. Being the newest modifier, I am sure you guys want to see more of her above all else. Before we continue, I do want to quickly reveal the winner of our first giveaway. So, congratulations to Amy Yost 7022, and a massive thanks to everyone who partake in it. We will be holding more giveaways on here and on Discord. For those of you who play Wuthering Waves, I have a lot of codes to give out, so keep an eye out for that. Alright, so we will be running 2 tests this time around. A solo test and a test using their best team comps, as well as some free-to-play options for our newest mods. I'll be back with some closing remarks, but for now, enjoy.
Jesus, I'll do it high. 私の歌はどうだった暁の闇描いて
ビオラは
決意の時
ねえ教師絶好の力がみなぎるこの程度かどうだ私の劇に爆音度はない
Yeah, so as you guys can see, the shadow element is back, in a big way here in version 3.4. By the way, this is the effect of Selene and Hades' skill chain. Go ahead and wrap your head around that one. If you're a fan of Hades, you definitely want to start saving for Selene. After using their skill chain, you don't have to worry about Divine Grace management, it's pretty wild. In terms of strength, I'd say Selene is stronger than Hades 100%. But when you take the synergy upgrades, and the fact that Double S is pretty much free now since she's a standard banner unit. You get the Jin Woo effect. Selene's single target damage was a bit concerning at first. I had to swap to yellow code to get that 14-second clear time even though blue is the better DPS line, but that's because she needs a little time to set up her rotation before the damage kicks in. As for Verthandi, I was expecting a little bit more from her, especially because she have her signature functor and ranks tier 0.5 like Selene. She's not weak by any means. In fact, she's pretty much in a Izanami situation where she's responsible for the entire team's damage. The same thing goes for Thoth. The difference is, both Thoth and Izanami have a dedicated support for their element. Something I know some of you will be surprised by is how competitive Heimdall and Okuni are. The two of them are very good supports and should not be slept on. I think this video have gone on long enough. And so, until we meet again, friends.
準備はいつでもバッチリです。
Thank you. 私の力が必要なのです。
拙者ならこちらに。
お姉さんに頼み事かしら？
話を聞かせてもらうよ。